inshallah ta'ala, the Fajr reflection today is going to be on the ayah that I recited in the first rak'ah, which is Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. I'm just going to focus on the first one I recited, which is Rabbi shrah li sadri. This concept of Allah expanding your chest.
Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. طه، ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى إلا تذكرة لمن يخشى، تنزيلا ممن خلق الأرض والسماوات العلا، الرحمن على العرش استوى، له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وما بينهما وما تحت الثرى، وإن تجهر بالقول فإنه يعلم السر وأخفى، الله لا إله إلا هو له الأسماء الحسنى، وهل أتاك حديث موسى، إذ رأى نارا فقال لأهلهم امكثوا إني آنست نارا، إني آنست نارا لعلي آتيكم منها بقبس أو أجد على النار هدى، فلما أتاها نودي يا موسى، فلما أتاها نودي يا موسى، إني أنا ربك فاخلع عليك، إنك بالوادي المقدس طوى، وأنا اخترتك فاستمع لما يوحى، إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري، إن الساعة آتية أكاد أخفيها لتجزى كل نفس بما تسعى، فلا يصدنك عنها من لا يؤمن بها واتبع هواه فتردى، وما تلك بيمينك يا موسى، قال هي عصاي أتوكأ عليها وأهش بها على غنمي ولي فيها مآرب أخرى، قال ألقها يا موسى، فألقاها فإذا هي حية تسعى، قال خذها ولا تخف، سنعيدها سيرتها الأولى، واضمم يدك إلى جناحك تخرج بيضاء من غير سوء آية أخرى، لنريك من آياتنا الكبرى، اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى، قال رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي، واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي هارون أخي، اشتد به أزري وأشركه في أمري، كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, إن شاء الله تعالى, the Fajr reflection today is going to be on the ayah that I recited in the first rak'ah, which is رَبِّ شَرَحَ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. I'm just going to focus on the first one I recited, which is رَبِّ شَرَحَ لِي صَدْرِي. This concept of Allah expanding your chest. As you can see, Musa alayhi salam, he was told, اِذْهَبْ إِلَى فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ طَغَى. Go to Fir'aun, he has transgressed, he has exceeded his limits. Go to Fir'aun. Look what Musa said. The first thing he asked was, رَبِّ شَرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي. He said, oh Allah, expand my chest. And he's very smart as a prophet, Musa alayhi salam, a smart, wise prophet. He knew what he needed in order to go and convey the message. He needed انشراح الصدر. Because Allah said in the Quran, أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ فَوَيْلٌ لِلْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. صح؟ Even Allah told the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said to him, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ. And this is مِنْ بَابِ الْإِمْتِنَانِ. Allah was telling the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, we have bestowed our blessing onto you by expanding your chest. And I know, mashallah, a lot of you who are here today already know the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. When he was a young kid, Jibreel came and he opened his chest and he cleaned what was inside the Prophet's chest. We all know that, right? The story. This was the انشراح الصدر that was taking place. So inshallah ta'ala, quickly, I want to go through 10 things. Okay, 10 things quickly, بإذن الله الكريم, that we can, inshallah ta'ala, achieve and its means for انشراح الصدر. I ask Allah to give it to us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you have a phone, action plan is to, بإذن الله, come with these 10 reasons for your chest to be expanded. Go home, inshallah ta'ala, and study it more, بإذن الله الكريم. Number one is توحيد الله عز وجل, singling Allah in worship. وإخلاص الدين له, and singling worship for Allah تبارك وتعالى. That is the first thing that a person needs. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. There are 10 things that you need to achieve انشراح الصدر. Number one is to single Allah in worship. You are on this earth to worship Allah. If you look at the first command in the Quran, what's the first command in the Quran? Start from Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Fatiha, Baqarah, Ali Imran. When you read Fatiha and you're into Baqarah, the first command that you come across is يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. This is the first command that you come across, صح؟ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Worship your what? Your Lord. What is the first prohibition you come across? فَلَا تَجْعَلُوا لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Do not associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So worshipping Allah is the first command, and staying away from shirk is the second, is the first prohibition that you come across. So the first is tawheed. That's what the ayah means. فَمَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَهْدِيَهُ يَشْرَحْ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ. Anyone who Allah wants to expand their chest, what does he do? He gives them Islam, meaning he gives them Tawheed. Number two, the second sabab al-thani is النور الذي يقذفه الله عز وجل في قلب عبده. This انشراح الصدر is a minnah من منن الله عز وجل. Allah is a blessing in from the blessings of Allah. So it's in His hand. You have to ask Him to give it to you. As you can see, what did the ayah say? فَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ فَهُوَ عَلَى. You're in light. You have light. That's what you're receiving. So it's a light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some of the great scholars like Ibn al-Qayyim and Ibn al-Muflih, and they mentioned this, that this nur is what Allah explains in another ayah. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانَ وَزَيَّنَهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصْيَانَ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الرَّاشِدُونَ. This is the blessing here, that they, number three, the third way to achieve it, or the first, third means is what? To attain beneficial knowledge. The people of knowledge are the people who what? Get this in Sharah al-Sadr. Are we all together? So Nabiullah Musa, when he said, قَالَ رَبِّ شَرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَحَلُّ الْعُقْدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accepted that dua for him by giving him what? Al-ilmu al-nafi', beneficial knowledge. And we know Allah said in the Quran, يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتِ. So Allah raises the station of who? The people of knowledge from amongst the ordinary Muslims. The Muslims are already raised. Okay, Allah already raised the believers. But then within the believers, Allah raised who more? The people of knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fourth, inshallah ta'ala, is al-inabatu ila Allah, to turn to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, wa husn al-iqbali alayhi. Ibn al-Qayyim al-Kubri said, he says, al-inabatu ila Allah, turning back to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, wa mahabbatuhu bi kulli al-qalbi, and loving him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the bottom of your heart, wal-iqbalu alayhi, and turning towards him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa tana'umi bi'ibadatihi, and enjoying the acts of worship, he says, fala shay'a ashraha li sadri al-abdi min dhalik. There is nothing greater than this for the expanding of the chest. So, repent. Consistently repent. The Prophet said in the hadith, alayhi salatu wasalam, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ فَإِنِّي أَتُوبُ فِي الْيَوْمِ مِئَةَ مَرَّةٍ. People, go back to Allah, repent, asking for forgiveness. I do this, he said, 100 times a day. Nabiullah Muhammad is saying, and we know in the Quran, Allah told us, إِنَّا فَتَحَنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. The Prophet, his sins are all forgiven. مع ذلك, he is asking Allah تبارك وتعالى. Number five, مداوم ذكر الله عز وجل. السبب الخامس is دوام ذكر الله عز وجل. أما ذكر الله عز وجل consistently, okay, دوام ذكر الله عز وجل consistently remembering Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Look what Allah said in the ayah, الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله. ألا بذكر الله, yeah? ما معنى تطمئن القلوب؟ يعني ينشرح به الصدور, it expands the chest for you. And this is انشراح الصدر, by the way, is basically what gets rid of anxieties and depression and all of these things. So, remembering Allah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. Remember Allah a lot. The ayah is powerful because it says remember Allah a lot. It doesn't say remember Allah this much. Meaning there's no limit to it. Just keep going on. If you've done 1,000 times, guess what? You can do 2,000. If you could do 2,000, make it 3,000. Keep going. The more you want inshirah al-sadr, the more dhikr you do. Okay, brothers. The sixth, inshallah ta'ala, is al-ihsanu ila ibadillah. Be good towards the people. Be nice to the people. وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Be good because Allah loves those people who are excellent and good. We're living at a time right now when people just don't want to be nice to other people. Rudeness and disrespect and angry and anger and frustration and all of that, we forget, be nice to the people. This is also a form of inshirah al-sadr. The Prophet already told us this. He said, مَنْ نَفَسَ عَمْ مُؤْمِنٍ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ الدُّنْيَا نَفَسَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كُرْبَةً مِنْ كُرَبِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَمَنْ سَتَرَ مُسْلِمًا سَتَرَهُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَاللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ الْعَبْدُ فِي عَوْنِ أَخِيهِ. So if you remove a distress from a Muslim brother, you come up to him and say, what's your problem? I can see you're sad. What is it that you need? I'm here for you. What can I do for you? And you remove that distress from him, Allah is going to remove it from you. Being nice to other people is the rent you pay for your room in Jannah. Are we all together, brothers? This, the caring and the good that we are towards others, we're paying for our rent in Jannah. And it doesn't hurt to smile in the face of your Muslim brother, sah, and to show them that you're happy to see them. So this is a way to achieve it, inshallah ta'ala. Number seven is ash-shaja'a, bravery and courage. Being very strong and brave in doing what is required from you, and also being brave as a Muslim. And now we're being nurtured upon what? To be cowardice and to... This is also what Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentions. And he got it from the ayah, إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَ. Shaytan is the one that places fear in the people's hearts. فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Do not be scared of Shaytan. Do not let Shaytan get to your heart. You're a Muslim, you're a mu'min. Why do you have to be scared for? Why are you afraid and scared and terrified? Okay? And this fear can sometimes enter different things. Sometimes the fear goes into stinginess. You're scared that you're never going to get money. You're going to die out of poverty. So I'm not going to get money. I can't give this money. I'm starving. You have this. You're scared all the time. Inshallah ta'ala, don't worry. The Lord that provided for you in the womb of your mother when you were not working for it is the one that's going to provide for you now that you're working for it. Are we all together, brothers? You're going out there, you're working, you're trying to make a risk for yourself. Who's going to provide for you? Allah. He gave it to you in the womb of your mother and you wasn't even working for it. Sah? وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ. So your risk is written. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet told us, عليه الصلاة والسلام, your provision is going to come to you just like death is going to come to you one day. It's written, everything's going to come to you. There's no way around it. Even if you wanted to avoid your risk, you can't. It's written. It's maktub. All together, brothers. Another, inshallah wa ta'ala, eighth, بإذن الله الكريم, is إبعاد أدواء القلوب وأسقامها. The heart, it becomes sick. Get away from these things that will cause harm to your heart. There are things that can affect the heart, that can make your heart feel bad. And you avoid it. You replace it with things that will bring the cure of the heart. So for example, music that people listen to when they're sad and they're down and they listen to these things and thinking they're going to get better for it, it will make you even more sadder. It will make your chest even more tighter. Sah? But what would make your heart expand your heart and make you feel better? The Quran. I promise you, brothers, if you listen to the Quran while you're driving, find a good reciter that you love and listen to the Quran. Yes, the Prophet did tell us. He says, alayhi salatu wasalam, زَيِّنُوا الْقُرْآنَ بِأَصْوَاتِكُمْ فَإِنَّ صَوْتَ الْحَسَنِ يَزِيدُ الْقُرْآنَ حُسْنًا. صح؟ A beautiful voice, what does it do for the Quran? It increases it in beauty. صح؟ So yes, if you do find that beautiful reciter that you like, when you listen to him, even though the Quran is already beautiful, it will make it what? Much more beautiful. And this is best for your heart, because what would it do? It would expand your chest. So the qa'ida is al-Qur'anu yuzilu al-amrad. The Quran will remove illnesses and sicknesses. Okay, brothers. Number nine. Okay, we've got two more left, inshallah ta'ala. Number nine is tarku fudulil kalami wal umur. Leave off unnecessary conversations. Stay away from things which are not necessary in your life. Sitting and gossiping about people and individuals and indulging yourself into matters that don't concern you will bring tightness of the chest. Are we all together? The qa'id and the principle for you as a Muslim is min husn al-islam al-mar tarku ma la ya'ni. Leave off what doesn't concern you. Does it have something to do with you? Yes, do it. And the things that you need to concern yourself with is the benefits of this world and the hereafter. Is it going to bring me worldly benefit? No, I don't need to know it. Is it going to bring me hereafter benefits? No, I don't need to know it. It's not my business. Are we all together? So don't concern yourself with don't put yourself in places or situations which doesn't concern you. It's got nothing to do with your life. Okay? Tarku fudulil umur. Leave of unnecessary situations, unnecessary things. Okay? Number 10, the last and final is husnu ittiba'i nabiyyil kareem. Following the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why is that the case? Because he is the one that was given an expanded chest. And we want to get it what he got. أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. Everything he did was the result of what? An expanded chest. Are we all together, brothers? So by following him to the T, صح? You are what? You're on that path. So inshallah ta'ala, رَبِّ شَرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي. We took today, inshallah ta'ala, from the Quran that we took, inshallah ta'ala. I ask Allah, he makes it a source of benefit for us. بارك الله فيكم وجزاكم الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
بارك الله فيك. ما شاء الله جزاه الله خير الجزاء شيخنا. ما شاء الله, that was very very beautiful. ما شاء الله, فجر reflection. We want to thank our Sheikh from the bottom of our hearts and say to him جزاك الله خيرا for spending these 2 days with us. الحمد لله, giving us beautiful فجر reflections, beautiful lectures, going through that, mashallah, amazing book, mashallah, Miftah Tariq Al-Awliya, mashallah, what a beautiful book that book was yesterday, alhamdulillah. So we want to thank the whole team, mashallah, who came with the Sheikh as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them immensely. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen. And may Allah protect his family and him, and mashallah, our Sheikh. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect his team as well, mashallah, the brothers who work with him. Barakallahu feekum, wajzakum Allah khair, and come and show your wonderful love to the Sheikh before he departs today, inshallah.